In this video, we are going to talk about Rendair AI, which is an AI tool for architects and designers. This will help you create architectural visualizations and renders from text, from 3D model views, or from sketches. Plus, you can edit these renders by selecting specific areas to modify, to remove elements, or even sketching directly on the image to develop the design even further. You can also upscale your images or create short videos with them. So today, I'm using the pro version to show you all the different tools. So this is the website. You can see here everything that it can do with some examples, and then you can just create a new account for free. So when you sign up, you will have this on your screen. There are different tabs here: learn, create, edit, upscale, or video. In the learn tab, you will find video tutorials and community creation. If you just get started, it can be useful to look here. Then you will have create. This is for creating a render from a description. This is for creating a render based on a 2D elevation, for creating a render based on a handmade drawing, to create a render based on a 3D base, and to create variations from an image. When you go to edit, you can find tools that will help you modify details in your images, to remove objects from your images, to create a render blending the image to added objects, or to sketch directly on your images and visualize them. When you go to upscale, this is where you can improve the quality of your image by upscaling and enhancing the texture. So we are going to start by creating different images, starting by text to render. I will just choose a style here, realistic for now. Up, confirm, and describe the scene. So I'm going to leave the creativity to 60% for now, and number of generation, I will just tap on 4 and generate. And this is what I have. Well, it's very nice, right? Look at the texture. It's amazing. So I tapped on generate again, and this time I got these renders. Well, it looks very nice. Well, I'm surprised about the quality of the materials, of the textures, you know. It looks very, very nice. Okay, let's try something else. Contemporary house with black framed windows, wood and stone cladding, and open concept, indoor, out. Door living, and generate. And this is what we got. Let's try something else. And this is what we have. Very nice, this one. It looks very realistic, by the way. Look at this. All right, let's try something else. And this is what we have. Well, I didn't write exterior, so it gave me interior. It's beautiful. Okay, let's try something else. And this is what we have. It's beautiful, right? Very nice, cute. Let's try something else. This is beautiful. I really like these colors. And this is what we have. I really, really like these colors. Look at that. Okay, let's try something else. And this is what we have. It's a different style, but I really like it. What do you think of this? All right, let's try something else. By the way, if you don't know what to write on the prompt section, you can click on add keywords here and it will help you find the right keywords on what you are searching. Okay, you can just select the view direction, the function type, the environment, the view type, the space type, the design style, material, weather, lighting, etc. It's very helpful. I always use this when I get out of ideas. Let's try a modern luxury villa with steel framed floor, ceiling, window. And this is what we have. The flowers are a bit too much, I think, but the design of the house is very nice. Here too. Now we are going to try something different. In the image style, we are going to choose artistic sketch. Style strength. Well, let's leave it at 100% and see for now. And this is what we have. Well, it's very cute. I love the colors. And this one too. It's very nice and very detailed. My favorites are this one and this one. Very, very nice. Okay. All right. Now I would like to try the elevation to render tool. Let's just add an image. I will just take some elevation view of the 3D sketches I made on Feather before. Image strength, I will leave it at 30%. A modern villa surrounded by garden. For the creativity, I will just leave it at 60%. You can also add a reference image. And number of generation, 4. And tap on generate. And this is what we have. Well, it stayed really true to the original images, so I really like it. You know, this is what I got by just writing a modern villa surrounded by garden. Like, if there's anything that you don't like about these images, you can just add whatever you would like to. Let's change, for example, write a modern villa surrounded by a forest next to a lake. Can use some keywords here. Let's say countryside villa, forest, and modern contemporary. Add, okay, and 4 up, and these are the results. Nice. So this is my sketch and this is the render. Come on, it's really nice. I mean, you get this just by drawing this, so yes, it's amazing. Anyway, let's try something else now. I have another elevation. I would just leave the prompt like this. All right, those are the results. They really look amazing. So this is my sketch. And yeah, it looks very nice. So it changed those lines into some small little windows and I really like it. Now I would like to try the sketch to render tool. And I will just upload my image. I had this sketch I drew before. Okay, let's try it. They look nice, right? I love the snow. Let's try something else. I will just upload a sketch of an interior now and see what we will have. And this is our renders. There are some confusion in here, but otherwise the others are good. I got this with just one sketch and a few words in just a few minutes. So you can just spend more time and add some other keywords and maybe add a reference image to play with the image strength and creativity. You will have a lot of different results. So let's try now 3D base to render. I will upload an image from a 3D model. Wait, I will just use the keywords residential building, suburban area, again, modern and contemporary, and that's it. Up, let's see. So these are our renders. So this is the 3D model view I uploaded, and this is what the AI gave me. I really like it. Let's see the others. Again, these are what I got in just uploading a 3D model view and a few words that I didn't even write. I used the keywords in here. So I literally spent just a few seconds doing that and I got these renders. Okay, before AI, I was using some rendering tools and the process of rendering an image was very long. So if you really want to show some alternatives to someone, you can just use an AI tool like this one to have different variation of your design with different materials, with different colors, and you get great results in a really short amount of time. And that's why it's amazing and really time saving. So now we are going to try the edit tool. So I will start with the select and modify. I'm just uploading one of the render we got before. So it tells me to mark the image for edits. So where are the parts we would like to change? We have the magic wand. Let's try it. So now we can see the different parts of our render. For example, let's say I want to change the sky. So I just select it. And now let's describe the things we would like to change. Cloudy sky with birds flying. And this is what we have. I think my favorite is this one because I don't want the birds to be that close. This one is nice. This one too. This was the render I uploaded and this is what I got. It's nice, right? Just tap on edit here and select and modify. Instead of using the magic wand, you can also select with a brush. You can change this tree in here. And let's write, for example, palm tree instead, okay? And this is our new renders. It's great. Can you see the difference? It just changed this tree into a beautiful palm tree. And it just fixed all the part of the building behind. Oh, and these are the others. It's also very nice. Well, this is another style of palm tree. It's also beautiful, but I think my favorite is still the first one, this one. And now we can add someone. I think we can add someone walking here in the garden. A man playing with his son, okay? And generate. And this is what we have. They are good. Here we have some problem with the face of this little guy, but the others are good, especially this one. Anyway, now we will try the tool remove object. So this is one of the render we made before. Let's remove this tree, okay? And yep, it removed the tree. That's great. So this is how it looks before and now without the tree. Now I will try the tool insert and modify. So here we can upload an image and we are going to write here a woman walking. So I've added this image. This is the woman. You can tap here to remove the background and tap on done. We can tap now on generate. This is what I uploaded and this is what the AI gave me. We can see that it really fits now. Can you see the shadings on the floor? It looks way more realistic. Great, we can try something else now. Now I added this one. Outdoor planter. And this is what we have. Well, it's really good. This one is better. We are going to try the sketch in context tool. I will just upload an image. So I will just add this render we made before, and I will use the pen tool in here to add another floor. So this is the result. I am actually impressed because I didn't expect it to understand my drawing. Come on, this is what I drew, okay? I drew this like in a few seconds, and look at my lines. And that's it. Let me show you the 4K upscale. You can choose the size here. Well, I will leave it like that. And let's see. I must say it takes some time to get those results. I have waited a few more minutes for it to upscale my images. The results are incredible. Let's zoom in like that. It's amazing. So this is the before, what I uploaded, and this is the after. I love it. Very, very, very nice. So let's try now the video tool. Let's see. And this is our video. Are you serious? I really like it. It looks very, very nice. I will try something else now. Here is the new video. I mean, come on, it's nice, it's amazing. And that's all for this video. Let me know what you think. I'm not gonna lie, it's amazing. I am truly surprised in how good this is. It's very accurate. By just writing a few words, we get incredible results. It gave me a lot of different examples with beautiful textures and materials, and I'm not even talking about the video part. Again, let me know what you think. I need to know. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. I have a 10% discount code. If you are interested, you can find the link in the description below. If you still have time and want to check my other videos about AI tools, you can find them on this playlist here. And see you in the next video. Bye!